everyone! My name is Tian Lin, and today we talk about all things related to the Provisioning Crafting skill line in the Elder Scrolls Online. I will explain for what provisioning is useful, show the skill line in depth, where you can gather recipes and ingredients, where you can find a cooking station, and how you can level up your provisioning skill line. If you are only interested in a specific topic, please take a look in the description. So, why should you think about to level up the Provisioning Crafting skill? Provisioning allows you to create useful meals and drinks which increase your health, magicka and stamina regeneration, or other useful bonuses for a set amount of time. Especially if you are interested in playing dungeons, trials or PvP, you want to be prepared and have your own food or drinks. But in general, it makes your adventures in Tamriel a lot easier if you don't miss these bonuses. When you don't want to invest so many skill points, or you don't want to collect and store all ingredients, you can also buy from guild traders your food and drinks. You can't use food and drinks at the same time, since they do not stack. But you can use food or drinks at the same time with an experience potion. Now we take a closer look at the skill line. Recipe quality will allow you to create green, blue, purple and legendary recipes. Recipe improvement allows the making of up to level 19, 29, 39, 49, Champion 50 and Champion 150 recipes. Gourmand is a really useful skill. It will add 5, 10 and 20 minutes to the duration of any eaten food. Connoisseur is also a skill which is good to have. It will add 5, 10 and 20 minutes to the duration of any consumed drink. That works also for crafted XP potions. If you plan to cook regularly for your characters, you should invest in a chef and brewer skill. For every dish or drink you make, you will create 1, 2 and 3 extra servings without spending additional ingredients. The hireling will find for you ingredients every 24 hours, which you will receive via mail. With 2 skill points invested, you will have a higher chance of receiving more ingredients every 24 hours. And when you invest 3 skill points, you can receive every 12 hours a hireling mail. Before we are able to start to cook our first meal, we have to find and learn cooking recipes. I believe at the moment you can collect up to 563 different recipes. At the start, you can only cook meals with recipes between level 1 to 19. But if you increase your provisioning skill line and invest into recipe improvement, you will be able to cook higher recipes too. You can find recipes as random drops in containers, such as cupboards and chests. If you have some gold, you can buy from guild traders recipes too. And for completing the daily provisioning writs, you will receive a random recipe depending on your recipe improvement knowledge. Don't forget that you can buy the needed recipes for the crafting writs from the chef and brewer in any pub in Tamriel. After you obtained your first recipes, you need to gather the needed ingredients. In general, provisioning ingredients can be found by searching barrels, baskets and crates in Tamriel. Meat can be gathered from various creatures throughout the world. For example, from elk, deer, rabbits, goats, chicken and many more animals which you can hunt in the Overland Zone. Grocers also sell ingredients, but have a limited selection and are also not cheap. If you have some gold, you can choose the faster solution and purchase ingredients from the guild traders. But if you take your time and just play the game, you will acquire over time a lot of ingredients. If you want to start to cook, you have to visit a cooking station. The provisioning skill line is granted when you visit a cooking station the first time. You find cooking stations in many cities in Tamriel. But I will show you now some example cooking places in the starter zones. In Nevin's Watch and Stone Falls you can visit the Watch House and the Fish Stink Inn. In Daggerfall in Kinumbra you find a cooking fire near the Drayman Square. And in Vulkegaard in Auridon you can visit the Salted Wings Tavern to find a cooking place. In general, you can find a cooking fire in camps, cities and inside houses everywhere in Tamriel, and they are easy accessible. Also, you are able to obtain a cooking fire for your house. You need 35 master wits to be able to purchase from the Master Mediator role list your personal cooking station. Or if you have the coin, you can buy with gold from the guild trader your personal cooking station for your home. I believe you have to invest around 35,000 gold for a crafting station. But keep in mind that the market prices can change all the time. Alternatively, you can buy for 2,400 crowns a cooking station for your house. Next, we talk about how you can level up your provisioning skill line. When you learn some recipes and gather the needed ingredients, you can start to cook meals and drinks at a cooking fire. Just by cooking, you will earn inspiration, which will increase the provisioning skill line. You can also increase your skill line by learning recipes, doing daily crafting writs and master crafting writs. And sometimes you can find books which increase your skill line too. If you reach level 50, you reach the maximum level for the provisioning skill line. In case you obtained already champion points, you can increase your inspiration gain. You have to invest 30 champion points into the tower to unlock a 20% inspiration boost. That will allow you to earn more inspiration and level up faster all crafting skill lines. Also, I would recommend you to take the time to do the daily crafting writs, which not only reward you with inspiration, but give you also gold, useful materials and also cooking recipes. Keep in mind that you need a lot of storage space to store all the available cooking ingredients. If you have ESO Plus, you will not have any problem, since all ingredients get direct stored into your craft bag. Otherwise, don't forget to increase your inventory and bank space, obtain storage chests, and if you still need more space, you can use extra characters to use the inventory as storage space. In case you play on PC, I would like to recommend you the add-on Cookery Wiz. Cookery Wiz is a super helpful and easy to use add-on, which will allow you to see every recipe available in the game. You can see what recipes your characters have and do not have, and you can share this information with other Cookery Wiz users too. It allows you to browse all recipes at any time, and it displays and calculates how many ingredients you have to use to cook, and many more useful things. You can find the add-on link in the video description. Every crafting station in the Elder Scrolls Online allows you to craft your own furnishings too. If you found and learned some furniture design plans, you can create, beside of food and drinks, also your own furniture at a cooking station. Visit any cooking fire, and at the top right you can switch to the furnishings tab. Depending on the item you want to build, you need to know multiple crafting skill line passives and obtain many different materials. To be able to craft furniture designs, you need decorative racks and other materials. You can find decorative racks by looting barrels, baskets, urns, crates, cabinets, etc. Hopefully you enjoyed my overview of the provisioning skill line in the Elder Scrolls Online. Thanks for watching, and it would be awesome if you subscribe, like or leave me a comment. Have a good day and until next time, tschüss!